So, as you know, it's the new syllabus which is introduced in 2018 for fixed income. On the face of it, it looks like it's completely changed, but it's not. They have taken bits and pieces of what was there in 2017 and added a few concepts or refined it. Am I audible? Clearly? Okay. So how I approached is, when I started studying, I followed the classic SQ 3RT approach. Have you heard of it? I mean, whenever you want to start something, you want to learn something new, this is what I try to do. You try to survey the topic before you start studying, as in just to kind of build curiosity. Then you do questions even before you have actually started reading the stuff, and then read, revise, recite. I didn't do all that, but yeah, I just read, and then you test yourself. So I'm thinking, just as an experiment, since we have a lot of time, I have opportunity to experiment on you guys. I'm going to do the same on you. So survey, it's a new topic, level 3 syllabus. And now I'm directly going to take you to questions. So we will practice, there are two case studies, and we'll practice them. We'll see how much we can answer. Even if you're not able to answer, at least we'll know what's there in the syllabus. And then I'll take you to respective learning outcomes. Is that a good idea? Okay, so let's see if we can do it together. So this is your first reading in the CFA Level 2 curriculum, first reading in the classroom. Introduction to Fixed Income Portfolio Management. It is an introduction reading. It's very high level. We don't drill down too much in depth. That we'll be doing in subsequent readings. But we kind of build a large perspective of the fixed income portfolio management world. Now the difference that you need to appreciate between the Level 2 fixed income and Level 3. Level 2, we were analysts in the fixed income segment, right? So we were building those binomial trees and we were doing those spot curves, forward curves, valuation. Now you're not an analyst anymore. Now you're a fund manager. So that's some growth. Now you don't get into too much of nitty-gritties. You look at things from more larger perspective, that which is a general theme at CFA Level 3. Now the strategy is, that I'm going to make you write down kind of the key summary of the crux of the topic. And then of course your notes are going to be your main revision material. We also need to keep on writing the whole season because we need to prepare ourselves for the morning section. Okay. Then I have also added a lot of examples in between so that we get opportunity to reinforce the concepts. Those examples, we will try to solve them as if we are approaching morning section. For example, we will read the example carefully, and then all of you would write down as if you are going to answer the morning section on CFA Level 3, so you would get some opportunity to practice there as well. So this is roughly your curriculum or syllabus for this particular reading. These are the sections in the curriculum. Number one is introduction, which is fairly basic. Then in section number two, we look at role of fixed income securities in the portfolio, where we essentially discuss why do we even need fixed income, what role do they serve, which has three subsections. It provides you diversification, it gives you regular cash flows, right, which is intuitive. It pays you coupon on a regular basis, and it has a potential for inflation hedging. Then third section is different mandates. In terms of when you recruit a fund manager, what do you tell him? So you tell him either manage money in such a way that my liabilities are taken care of, think of defined benefit plans, or manage money in such a way that my return of my investors are maximized. So that could be total return mandates. Then in section four, we discuss about liquidity. Okay, so essentially they've discussed in this section why bond market liquidity differs significantly than equity market's liquidity. So liquidity among the bond market subsectors, which means are corporate bonds more liquid or treasuries more liquid? You know, discussion like that. Then the effects of liquidity on fixed income portfolio management. So as a fund manager, what decisions you should take depending on your investment horizon and your liquidity preference. Then section 5, a model for returns. This is where we learn to decompose. So some of the mathematics that we would be doing here in this particular section. Section 6 is about leverages. We'll learn to do some fancy calculation. And then in the 7th section, we will have discussion on taxation. This is roughly how we are going to progress through the readings. And these are all the subparts. Okay. So let us start with the introduction part here. Fixed income markets represents largest asset class in the financial markets. Now, if you're in a developing market like India, we are not exposed to much of fixed income because we have more or less larger equity markets and lesser retail participation in fixed income markets. But in European and American markets, the size of fixed income is much more larger than the size of equity markets. Second point, fixed income markets include publicly traded and non-publicly traded instruments. Can you tell me some? Publicly traded, treasuries or corporate bonds, government bonds, non-publicly traded, private placements, loans. Right? As a bank, you're giving loan to someone. Is that a fixed income asset? Yes, but it is a non-publicly traded. Then the reading will discuss why investor portfolios should have fixed income securities. What roles do they have in the portfolios? Then we will have discussion on liability-based mandate and total return mandate. And then we will have discussion on how do you decompose the return that we earn on a fixed income portfolio.